Bond yield has spiked up pretty sharply over the course of last 2 months, primarily on the back of INR depreciation, which we have witnessed over the course of last 3 months. In fact, the entire curve has suffered. We have seen a close to 100 basis point spike in the 10-year benchmark bond. The corporate bond have spiked up by close to 200 basis point. Certificate of deposit, commercial paper itself has seen erosion of 200 basis point as far as curve is concerned. This thing is going to continue in the near term. Over a course of time, we feel that once volatility subsides on the currency space, RBI is going to take these measures back, and that context will have normalization as far as market is concerned. If currency continue to show more pain in the near term, in the foreseeable future, then perhaps RBI will have to change the structure of the entire interest rate dynamics. It could be by way of hiking the CRR or itself hiking the reverse repo and repo rate as well. So that is something which is absolutely not ruled out given the dynamics of macro environment that we are in as of now. Obviously, growth is a problem in the near term. I mean, we are not seeing any sign of fresh, impetus which can boost growth. So in that context, next 4-6 quarters are likely to be subdued. At the same time, inflation, though, especially the core inflation, though it's subdued as of now, you could have inflationary pressure building up because of, I'll say, currency play for that matter. For risk-averse investors, since the shorter end of the curve is still elevated, one could look at, locking into shorter end of the curve, which is basically FMP's categories. One could still continue to be in the shorter end of the curve by being in short-term plan as well. The guys who can take incremental risk at the margin, we still advocate duration play by being in active categories fund or dynamically managed portfolios, wherein you can actually change the stance of the portfolio in accordance with the evolving macros.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.